The graphics processing unit, or GPU for short, is a specialized electronic circuit for digital image processing, or in simple terms, it generates the image output from your computer to your monitor. It is also commonly called a video card, although this isn't the most accurate term when referring to the integrated graphics within a CPU. Originally, the function of the GPU was to render images and videos for a display, but nowadays, GPUs have gained popularity for their ability to handle various tasks, such as AI model training, cryptocurrency mining, and large-scale parallel mathematical computations. This is because, unlike a CPU, which performs operations sequentially, a GPU can perform many operations in parallel. While the GPU cores aren't very powerful individually, their much higher core count makes them ideal for performing many simple operations simultaneously, such as pixel calculations, completing them faster than a CPU and reducing its workload. It is worth mentioning that inside the GPU, there are different core types, each specialized for a specific task. Shader cores, called CUDA cores in NVIDIA cards, and stream processors in AMD cards are the most numerous and are used for simple calculations. Tensor cores handle matrix operations, making them ideal for machine learning and working with neural networks. Ray tracing cores are the largest and are responsible for calculating light reflections on surfaces, creating more realistic gaming experience. Some GPUs have a higher count of specific core types, making them better suited for particular tasks. For example, the NVIDIA B100, which is optimized for machine learning workloads. GPUs are divided into two types, integrated and dedicated. The integrated graphics chip is usually built on the same silicon die as the CPU or at least shares the same integrated heat spreader. Integrated graphics are typically low powered and share the system RAM with the CPU. They provide the basic level of performance suitable for casual users while not significantly increasing the power consumption. This makes the integrated graphics the preferred choice for laptops and mini PCs. External GPU enclosures are also available on the market, allowing users to connect a more powerful GPU to a laptop or a mini PC when needed. However, keep in mind that the performance with most enclosures nowadays won't match that of a card installed in a desktop due to the connection interface typically not providing enough bandwidth for higher-end video cards. The dedicated graphics card is a separate component inserted into a dedicated slot. Nowadays, the most commonly used slot is the PCI Express. You can learn more about it in this video. But you might still encounter some older computers using PCI or AGP slots. Dedicated GPUs usually provide higher processing power and feature separate RAM soldered onto the PCB called VRAM. While sharing a similar name, VRAM is different from the regular dynamic RAM. It is often slower and has higher latency, but offers greater bandwidth and the ability to be accessed in parallel, which suits the GPU workloads better. Like regular RAM, VRAM has evolved through several generations, each improving in speed and bandwidth. Early VRAM used the DDR technology, slightly optimized for graphics use, but as GPU demands grew, a newer version called GDDR2 was introduced. This memory used technology that was a midpoint between DDR and DDR2, and from that point on, newer graphics memory versions no longer match the numbering of standard SDRAM. Some cards even use regular DDR2 SDRAM, causing an additional confusion in the early 2000s. Currently, 7 main generations of VRAM have been introduced, along with 2 midpoint versions labeled with an X at the end. Typically, a higher number indicates increased transfer speeds and bandwidth. The latest version is GDDR7, available in NVIDIA's RTX 50 series video cards. Since GPUs are no longer used solely for video rendering and gaming, a specialized type of VRAM was created, known as High Bandwidth Memory or HBM. Like GDDR, it has gone through multiple generations, with HBM3E being the latest. This type of memory, as the name suggests, provides significantly more bandwidth than the traditional GDDR memory by stacking multiple DRAM dies vertically. It also consumes less power and takes up less space. Originally, dedicated GPUs were powered directly through the motherboard slot they were plugged into. However, as power demands grew beyond the 75-watt limit of the PCI Express slot, additional power connectors from the PSU were introduced. These include 6-pin and 8-pin connectors supplying 75 watts and 150 watts respectively. Some newer video cards require multiple connectors. That's why Nvidia introduced new high power connector with Nvidia's RTX 30 Founders Edition series, capable of delivering up to 600 watts. This connector was short-lived as it was replaced by the 16-pin 12-volt high power connector in the RTX 40 and 50 series. More powerful GPUs generate a significant amount of heat, which is why they're typically equipped with large heat sinks and multiple fans to maintain a safe operating temperature. To further improve cooling and allow for high performance, some high-end GPUs come with built-in liquid cooling solution or are compatible with custom water cooling setups. Currently, there are three major manufacturers in the dedicated graphics cards: Nvidia, AMD, and Intel. Nvidia holds a strong lead in the dedicated graphics segment, followed by AMD, while Intel has a very small share. In the integrated graphics market, Intel has an advantage because its CPUs have historically been more widely sold and used. However, it is worth noting that AMD's integrated graphics have generally performed better in recent years. Nevertheless, Intel is quickly closing the gap with improvements in its latest CPUs, so you might want to keep an eye on its latest Intel Core Ultra 200 and the upcoming 300 series mobile CPUs. I hope this video helped you get a basic understanding of the GPU. If you found it helpful, please give it a like and consider subscribing to watch more similar content. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to leave a comment below. Thanks for watching.